Randy, great to see you again. How are you?
Good. We wrapped up our first weekend of marching band, at least in Indiana, and I'm sure in several other places of the country. So tell me about your week one observations. I'll throw some things in there too.
Well, it's just great to see bands out for the first time. Of course, just like they say in baseball, it's early, you know, so there's still a lot for all the groups to do, but I was just proud of the directors and kids for getting everybody out there and getting things going. You know, some people did half of their show, some people did a third of their show, but they got their kids out there. And the one show that I was at, the Brownsburg Invitational, which I think you were at also, had a great crowd. Man, the crowd was just tremendous. Like the stadium was almost packed. So I thought for September 10th, especially, that was really great. So congratulations to all those groups that got things out there ready to go. And Randy, you and I did this for many years, so we know what they're dealing with. They're trying to get their show out there, but they're also trying to get their kids to march and play well and become good performers, good musicians, good visual artists. And it's tough to do. And I think I would just remind everyone to just not go too quick. You know, make sure that you're sticking to your guns on basics. You know how Randy and I feel about basics and fundamentals, and make sure you take some time every week to go back and check on how you're sounding, check on how you're marching, your posture, all those basic things, because we all know that's going to pay off down the road.
Absolutely, Richard. And, you know, I think that the groups that were successful in terms of translating their show to the audience this weekend were those groups that you can tell they spend time on fundamentals and they connect the dots for the students so that there's a cohesion between the fundamental process of what they're able to do with their skill sets and what the show offers. And that makes a world of difference, doesn't it?
Absolutely. You know, anytime early September where you can listen to a group and say, wow, that's a really nice sound out there, that's quite a compliment, you know, to the directors and to the kids, because you know there's been some good fundamental work done. And when the color guard looks like they're becoming even pretty much professional looking this early in September, that's pretty amazing too. So I think there's a lot of things going on, but just a reminder to directors not to get too caught up in scores, not to get too caught up in judges' tapes, and just do what's best for your kids.
In terms of, you know, and I know we're going to be doing our weekly webinar, or I'm sorry, our monthly webinar this Wednesday on Facebook Live. But, you know, what are some observations that you've had and with some of the groups that you've worked with in terms of how they approach the ensemble rehearsal, getting prepared for that first contest or any contest for that matter? What's early season? What's the approach with the ensemble rehearsal?
Well, one of the things that I see pretty consistently is that folks go from their typical rehearsal process to more of a full ensemble process to give kids plenty of experience out on the field, marching and playing. Because let's be honest, most groups have been working on their music, they've been working on their drill, the color guard's been working on their routine, and now they're trying to put everything together. And so I think it's a matter of maybe getting a little bit more ensemble in, which I think is great. But again, I'm going to keep encouraging, as you and I always do, keep encouraging folks to make sure that there's time every week to go back to just playing, go back to just drill, you know, and wait maybe till the end of the week to put things together, no matter what week it is. Because we all know that success at the beginning of the season starts with fundamentals, and success at the end of the season ends with fundamentals. So I know people are probably tired of me saying that, but we've just seen it happen so many times that the groups that stick to their guns on those kind of things all season long are the ones that we're talking about at the end of the year.
Absolutely. Well, thanks so much for the conversation this morning, Richard. Look forward to a great week ahead, and we'll see everybody next week on another episode of Coffee Talk.
Yeah, have a great week of rehearsals, everybody. Take care.